Hey, this is my third take of this video because the other times I just kind of like, I sucked. I've been like all over the place lately, but I'm really excited to show off some toys I've gotten at some shows I've gone to recently. I went to Albany Comic Con and the Upstate New York Collectors Show. I got some cool stuff and I'm gonna show it off real quick. Not even gonna try to make it a long video because the first couple times I did, not this week. But first of all, here's this Barbie. It's the Elizabethan Queen. It's from the 1994 Great Eras collection. And she was a hot $10. And look at this dress. Damn, Barbie, great job. The box looks really good, and it opens up with this nice window for display. I'm not sure if I'll leave her in there. I don't like when Barbies can't breathe in their boxes. But also from Albany Comic Con. Oh yeah. What Barbie would be complete without an off-brand office set? Very beautiful, very cute. I'm not sure what off-brand it is, but if it's every 11 and a half inch doll. And Barbie, it's very clearly Barbie on the cover. I want to say the off-brand they marketed it as had some like P name, like Patsy or something like that. But Barbie is the background on her computer, which is an absolute power move. And her copier says, "My copier," in rainbow letters. So don't even think of using it, Ken. Not for Ken dolls. This is Barbie's. And I'm probably gonna set that up. There's like a lot of little pieces in there, but I really want to use it for my Anakin Skywalker Hot Toys figure. Next show, Upstate New York Collector Show. This is where I got the really cool stuff. That show's great if you want like old toys, and that's like what I always want is old toys. And I found some stuff that I had definitely wanted. First off being this beautiful gem lunchbox. It's yellow. It's kind of dirty, needs some cleaning up. It has this art on it, which is the weird art that was on the box for the gem dolls. The artist is actually really cool. I think I found her Instagram once. But I really, really like the aesthetic, even if it's not the same aesthetic as the 80s cartoon they made to sell the dolls. But yeah, it definitely needs some cleaning. But once I clean it up, I'm probably gonna use it as a purse for like my gem cosplays. And because, like, what's more badass than having a lunchbox with yourself on it? This was only $8, which is an absolute steal. The next item is this very beautiful Dreamy Sweets doll. Her hair definitely needs some work. And, yeah, she's got, like, a nice bald spot going on. But I'm gonna boil straighten it and see what I can do for her. Her face needs to be washed a little bit. And she's really cute. Dreamy Sweets was a doll line in the early 90s, 80s or 90s that died out. She was $11, but I love her. And the cool thing about this Dreamy Sweets doll, she works. Her little light up wand lights up. Worth it for the $11 alone. And also, she's got such a cute face. How could you say no to Dreamy Sweets? Nextly, actually, you know what? I'll save that for last because it's really, really cool. I'll show you the stuff I got thrifting first. This Pokemon box. For just $1, it's got some like old Pokemon art on it. Might have been $2, but still very worth it. And it's got like a hole in the top for a bank and somebody's Bugs Bunny stickers, some glitter nail polish. Somebody had a good time with this. I'm not sure if I'll use it to hold Pokemon cards or if I'll use it as an actual bank. But either way, it's very cool and I really like this photo on the back. And this is from 1998. I got some VHS tapes for $1 each. The first one being Barbie and the Sensations, which I assume is like Barbie and the Rockers, but I'm not too sure. Oh, also includes Barbie and the Rockers. Strap yourself in because the countdown to actions about Barbie to begin. Not very good English, but I'm gonna watch it anyway. Approximate running time is 55 minutes. I'm gonna bust out the VCR. It's gonna be a great time. I really like the art on the front cover. It was a good find. Even if the cartoon is meh, the art on the box is really cool, so we'll see. Secondly, the Sailor Moon Super S movie, which isn't on DVD or Blu-ray anywhere, but it probably will be soon because I think they announced it's going to theaters. This is the best Sailor Moon movie. The best one, I think. I haven't seen it in a long time because the VHS copy I had since I was a child, I opened it up to watch it one day and the VHS inside was Toy Story 2. So I was kind of really heartbroken because Toy Story 2 is the weakest of the Toy Story movies. But anyway, I really like the like clamshell VHS cases. And I like that it has the right VHS inside, so I can possibly watch this again before it goes to theaters. And plus that has like the older dub on it. The new one is probably gonna have the newer dub. So that's cool. That's cool. I didn't think of that before. And now I'll talk about the last thing I got because it's really, really cool. It's in great condition. This vintage Lisa Frank box. It's like a jewelry box. They're made out of like cardboard and not plastic, so I've never seen one in this good condition. And it's kind of like clean. Most everybody kept like glitter and crayons in them, so they kind of got destroyed. It's got the art on the inside as well. And I particularly love this art for a lot of reasons. Mostly because she's sitting on a moon. I like moons. It's kind of holographic and very pretty, a very good color scheme. But also, she's got orange hair and green eyes. And I have green eyes and I like to have orange hair. So I feel like this little Lisa Frank girl could be me. And I'm probably gonna keep makeup palettes in here. But it looks absolutely really good for how not durable these things are. I was really excited to find this. Got it at the Upstate New York Collector Show, and it was 20 whole dollars, but it's absolutely gorgeous. I made a new Instagram, mostly for posting my toys and cute things. Probably some selfies and cosplay will sneak on there eventually. But the username is Dreamy Sweets, and it's named after this doll. Little Dreamy Sweets here. And I mostly made it because I needed an account that I didn't have to stress on. I get overwhelmed with a lot of the messages and like local people and stuff, but the Dreamy Sweets account, real chill, cute stuff all day. You can follow it if you'd like. And yeah, thanks for the support, thanks for watching my video, thanks for enjoying all my cute toys with me. Yeah, that's it, that's all I had to say. I love you, have fun.